Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. Let's do some examples of sp3 hybridized atoms. So on the screen we have a pretty big table, and over the course of this video we will populate all the cells in this table. But first, let's begin on the right and think about the atomic orbitals we have in our valence shell of a second row element. We have an s and four p's, and for sp3 hybridization we're going to combine all four of these atomic orbitals, and we're going to create four new atomic orbitals, four sp3 hybrids. So the original orbitals are gone. They've been used up to make four new orbitals, new atomic orbitals. Now, we need all four of these orbitals because we have to satisfy the octet rule, and the four atomic orbitals times 2 electrons per orbital will give us our needed 8 electrons of capacity around these atoms. So let's look at our structures. Number one in our table is methane. The carbon in methane is attached to four hydrogen atoms. So A equals 4. We have 0 lone pairs on carbon, so L equals 0. A plus L equals 4. If A plus L equals 4, we need sp3 hybridization. The geometry of an sp3 hybridized atom with four attached atoms is tetrahedral. The predicted bond angle is approximately 109.5, and in fact the experimental bond angle is also 109.5, so great match between predicted and experimental value. Molecule number two is ammonia. Ammonia has nitrogen in the middle. Nitrogen has three attached atoms, three hydrogens. It has one lone pair, A plus L equals 4. That leads us to sp3 hybridization. The geometry of an sp3 hybridized atom with three attached atoms is trigonal pyramidal. I'm just having all kinds of problems. Let's try that over. Okay, trigonal, let's erase. Again, I'm trying to write trigonal pyramidal. Trigonal pyramidal. Much better. The predicted bond angle is 109.5, and the experimental angle is around 107. So again, nice agreement. Molecule number three is water. Water has, the oxygen has two attached hydrogens. It has two lone pairs, A plus L equals 4, leading us to sp3 hybridization. The geometry of an sp3 hybridized atom with two attached atoms is bent. We would predict a 109.5 for all sp3 hybridized atoms, and the experimental value is about 104.5. Good match. Now, molecule number four, methanol, has two second row elements, so we'll start with carbon. This carbon has four attached atoms, three hydrogens and an oxygen, no lone pairs, A plus L equals 4. It's sp3 hybridized. It has a tetrahedral geometry, and I'll abbreviate that, a predicted bond angle of 109.5, and the bond angles experimentally indeed are really close to 109. Finally, the oxygen. This oxygen has two attached atoms, a carbon and a hydrogen. It has two lone pairs, A plus L equals 4. That leads us to sp3. Its geometry is bent. 109.5 is what we predict. And indeed, again, the bond angle is very close to 109 degrees. So those are just some quick examples of sp3 hybridized atoms and how to work through determining what their bond angles and geometries are.